it's Ariana, and out of all the dishes people have asked me to make, this Filipino adobo probably takes spot number one. With world travel being really difficult right now, and it feeling like we're more distant than ever, I want to use my platform to cook more dishes from around the world. I hope that by doing this, I'll be able to shed light on the amazing cuisine and culture around us and help bring everyone a little closer. This is my first time making adobo, and it was absolutely amazing. I started by marinating the chicken in half a cup of soy sauce and 5 cloves of garlic. Then I seared it on both sides until it was nice and golden and poured the marinade back over plus a cup and a half of water and added the lid. After I brought this mixture to a boil, I added 3 bay leaves, a teaspoon of black peppercorns, and then added the lid again and simmered it for about 30 minutes on low. Then I sprinkled on 1/4 teaspoon of salt, 1 tablespoon of coconut sugar, and 4 tablespoons of white vinegar, simmering this for another 10 minutes. Adobo is traditionally served with rice and a good drizzle of the sauce. An amazing 27% of my followers come from the Philippines, so friends, let me know how I did and comment which dishes I should try next. Full recipes on my Instagram. Hey everyone, it's Ariana, and I'm going to show you how to make these adorable apple hand pies. They're perfect for fall, and they're so fun to make. In a mixing bowl, add 2.5 cups of flour, 1/4 cup of sugar, 1/2 teaspoon of salt, and then 1.5 sticks of cold butter cut into cubes. Then pour in 1/2 cup of cold milk or water, and then knead it in using your hands until the dough is formed. Stick that into the refrigerator to chill while we make the filling. In this mixture, I have 4 finely chopped apples, and then to that I added 1 teaspoon of cinnamon, 1 teaspoon of nutmeg, 1/4 cup of maple syrup, and then 2 tablespoons of cornstarch, which thickens it all up, and then a little sprinkle of salt, and there we have it. I took the chilled crust out of the fridge, sprinkled it on both sides with flour, and then rolled it out to the thinness I liked, cut it out using a little cutter, and then added the apple filling a little bit in the middle, and then used egg washer on the outside to help the top crust stick to the top. I also poked a couple holes at the top to vent, and then brushed them with some egg wash, and then added these little leaves and stems that I made with the extra pie dough to make them look like apples, and then finish it off with a little more egg wash. Sprinkle with sugar, and then bake at 350 degrees for about 40 minutes. Full recipes on my Instagram as always, and follow for more. Hey everyone, it's Ariana, and today's officially the first day of October, so to celebrate, we're gonna be making a pumpkin spice latte inside of a pumpkin. You heard that right. I recently picked up this pumpkin from the farm and could not decide what to do with it until I saw this idea on Chef Nick DiGiovanni's page, and I was like, oh, yep, that's the one. After scooping out the seeds and guts from the pumpkin, I used a knife to cut out a little bit of the flesh and then sprinkled it with sugar and melted butter and took it to the oven. After roasting it for about 20 minutes at 400 degrees, I pureed it in the food processor, and then it was time to assemble the drink. Into the saucepan, I poured 1 huge cup of espresso, milk, 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract, ground ginger, ground nutmeg, ground cinnamon, a handful of cloves, a little drizzle of maple syrup, and of course our pumpkin puree. You can also just use pumpkin pie spice instead of the spices I used and whatever sweetener you like. After bringing the coffee mixture to a simmer on the stove, I poured it back into our pumpkin half, topped it with whipped cream and some more nutmeg. I seriously couldn't dream of a better use for this pumpkin. It was so good. You've got to try this out and follow for more food. Hey everyone, it's Ariana, and we're making this classic Hawaiian ahi tuna poke bowl, probably one of my favorite foods of all time, and it's so colorful and delicious. I start by marinating 2.5 pounds of sushi-grade ahi tuna with 1/4 cup of soy sauce, 1 tablespoon of rice vinegar, 2 tablespoons of sesame oil, a little pinch of chili flakes, and 3 sliced scallions. Then just assemble the bowl with rice and whatever toppings you like. I first added the fish and then some sliced radishes, red cabbage, cucumbers, carrots, and of course some sliced avocado, topping it off with some more scallions and sesame seeds. Let me know how I did, what I should make next, and check out the full recipe on my Instagram. Hey everyone, it's Ariana, and today my grandma's dog Link, aka one of my best friends in the entire world, had to go get shot, so to cheer him up, I made him these homemade pumpkin and peanut butter treats. These are his favorites, so I'm gonna show you how to make it for a dog in your life. In a mixing bowl, add 2.5 cups of whole wheat flour, 3 heaped teaspoons of peanut butter, 1 cup of canned pumpkin, 2 eggs, plus 1/2 teaspoon of cinnamon, which is really good for people and dogs, and 3/4 cup of rolled oats. And then mix it all up until you have a nice thick dough. I ended up just giving up on the spatula and kneading it together with my hands, and then turn it over onto the countertop. Use some flour if you need to make sure it doesn't stick, and then roll it out. I use these little cookie cutters to make it into these cute heart shapes. Transfer your treats over to a baking sheet, and then I used the extra dough, kneaded it back together, and then rolled it out some more to make the rest to fill up the sheet. Bake your treats at 350 degrees for 40 minutes until they're all dried out. And for the taste test, let me know if I should change my career and become a chef for dogs, and follow me on Instagram for more recipes. Hey everyone, it's Ariana, and I'm gonna show you how to make these amazing oven roasted honey and sriracha glazed chicken wings. They're so delicious and so easy to make. The secret to getting them super crispy in the oven is to add a teaspoon and a half of cornstarch plus a teaspoon of salt. Give that a good toss and then transfer it to a wire rack on a baking sheet to help the air circulate. Start by baking them at 250 degrees for about 30 minutes. This is gonna help dry off the outside and get them super crunchy. Then crank up the heat to 425 and bake for 15 minutes more. For the sauce, mix together half a cup of sriracha, 3 tablespoons of honey, and 2 tablespoons of melted butter. You can have whatever sauce you like, but I'm telling you, this combo is so good. Toss your chicken wings in the sauce and then garnish with whatever you like. I use some fresh parsley and that's it. I really hope you give this a try and follow my TikTok and Instagram for more. Hey everyone, it's Ariana, and if you dabble on food TikTok, you've definitely seen this Tangulu trend. It's this super fun and crunchy dessert that originated in China. When I tried this recipe for the first time, it ended up getting over 7 million views on TikTok, which is absolutely insane. And since then, I've made this dessert so many times, I wanted to share with you some of my favorite tips to make sure yours comes out perfect. To make that signature crunchy coating on the outside, all you need is a half a cup of sugar plus a fourth of a cup of water. Give it a little swirl in the pan, but do not stir. If you do, it causes this crazy reaction in the sugar, and it immediately crystallizes like this. Have no fear though, your pan isn't ruined. Just pour some water over it, bring it back to a boil, and then the sugar is gonna dissolve and you can just pour it all out. Take your sugar solution and bring it to a boil on the stove until it turns to this nice golden color that you can dip your fruit in using skewers. Be careful because it's super hot. You're also gonna want to avoid using fruits that are super moist on the outside like kiwis. I was so excited about making kiwi tangulu, but it just did not work out because the sugar mixture would not stick. I hope this helps and let me know if you give it a try. Hey everyone, it's Ariana, and yesterday we recreated the iconic Pasta Queen's classic homemade gnocchi recipe. Today I'm going to show you how to make the insanely delicious brown butter and sage sauce that goes with them. This is the easiest pasta sauce ever, and it's literally good on almost anything. Honestly, just dip a piece of bread in, you will not regret it.
Ingredients.
Start by adding about a fourth of a cup of butter cut into cubes to a pan and then add in a bunch of sage leaves. Then let everything melt down and sizzle in there. You're gonna wanna get it super dark, so don't be afraid if it gets really brown. The more dark it is, the more flavor it's gonna have. And then add in your pasta of choice. I use the gnocchi we made yesterday. Give it a stir and then pour in about a fourth of a cup of your pasta water. This helps get it super creamy, and the starches in the pasta water give it the most amazing texture. Give it a little season with some salt and then stir it around again. And that's it. If you want the easiest entry to making homemade pasta sauce, this is absolutely for you. I was so blown away by how delicious it was, and it's literally only 3 ingredients, so no excuses. I really hope you give this recipe a try and follow my TikTok and Instagram for more. Hey everyone, it's Ariana, and on the last video I made this gigantic pumpkin spice latte inside of a pumpkin I picked at the farm. I hope you saved the seeds because today I'm going to show you how to make these amazing pumpkin spice pumpkin seeds. If you've never roasted your own pumpkin seeds before, it's so easy and these are hands down the best I've ever made. Step 1 is to separate the seeds from all the pumpkin guts and set them onto a tray, patting them dry with a paper towel to make sure they get nice and crunchy in the oven. Then I drizzled the seeds with about 2 tablespoons of melted butter, a teaspoon of maple syrup, and then about a quarter teaspoon of cinnamon, a quarter teaspoon of nutmeg, and then a quarter teaspoon of ground ginger. And then finally gave them a little sprinkle of some sea salt. After that, transfer your seeds to the oven and roast them at 300 degrees low and slow for about 45 minutes. After they come out of the oven, they should be all crackly and golden and gorgeous and caramelized. My little brother and I single-handedly consumed an entire pumpkin's worth of seeds in one sitting, and it was so worth it. I really hope you give this recipe a try and follow for more. Hey everyone, it's Ariana, and this is everything I made tonight as a teen private chef. Because of the coronavirus, this is the first dinner I've cooked in 8 months, so I wanted to make it really special. For the first course, I made blini, which are these little buckwheat pancakes topped with creme fraiche, smoked salmon, black caviar, and a little bit of fresh dill, and my own pickled radish. Course 2 was an heirloom tomato Napoleon with burrata cheese and basil. And then for the third course, I made a Tuscan ribollita, which is a white bean soup with kale and a toasted baguette topped with some shaved parmesan. The fourth course is one of my all-time favorite foods. I made handmade pasta with a peppercorn cream sauce and some sautéed mushrooms and asparagus. Then I made an herb-basted ribeye with a red garnet yam puree and maple-roasted Brussels sprouts. And finally, for dessert, I made homemade vanilla bean ice cream with warm berries and an oat crumble. I cook these private dinners to help raise money for charitable causes that I'm passionate about. I can't believe we've been able to raise now over $500,000. Hey everyone, it's Ariana, and I'm going to show you how to make the perfect steak. This is a classic. Sear to golden perfection on the outside and baste it with butter, garlic, and herbs. A not so subtle flex, but a few short years ago, this is the dish that ended up getting me on MasterChef Junior, so I trust the process.
Restaurant quality beyond belief. Absolutely the dish of the night. Ariana!
Step 1 is to season your steak of choice. I used ribeye with salt and pepper on both sides. Then I get a super hot cast iron pan, add oil, get that super hot, and then add the steak in there. After about 3 minutes, the steak should be perfectly golden on one side, so flip it over and get the other side. Now here's the secret. After the steak is seared on both sides, I add in 2 crushed cloves of garlic, a bunch of fresh herbs like rosemary, thyme, and sage, and a couple tablespoons of butter, and baste that over the steak. This creates an oven around the steak, which helps infuse it with all those flavors and cook it to perfection. Chef Ramsay, if you're watching this, I hope I made you proud. Hey everyone, it's Ariana, and I was recently dragged on one of my previous videos for not eating these rambutan fruits right. This video had over 25,000 comments and hundreds of videos showing me how to do it right, just like this one.
No, that's not how you eat it. It's like... Okay, you so like...
You already know I watched as many of these videos as I could, and you best believe I'm gonna take the feedback. So, step number one, you take your rambutan, and you bite the top. You do not use a knife. That was my mistake number one. You bite the top like this. And then it'll pop open and you open it and then you peel off the skin and you should have the fruit like this. Now you do not take the knife and cut it off. You put the whole thing in your mouth like this. And then after you eat everything, you spit out the seed, and that is how you properly eat a rambutan. Let me know if I did this right and I will see you soon. You asked for ratatouille, and best believe I'm gonna deliver. There is absolutely no debate that the ratatouille from the movie looked unbelievably good, and I'm gonna try and do that justice today. We start off by slicing 1 to 2 zucchinis, yellow squashes, tomatoes, eggplants, and then get a pan super hot, add olive oil, and then 1 red bell pepper and 1 yellow bell pepper. I picked some fresh basil from the garden and then added it to the peppers along with a clove of garlic and 28 ounces of crushed tomatoes. Next, give it a sprinkle of some salt and pepper and then give it a little stir. And then we artfully arrange all of our veggies. I started out with a stack of the 4 and then swirled it around until I made it to the end and seasoned it up with some salt and pepper. The crown and glory that goes on top of this ratatouille is the herb mixture. It's a little bit of thyme, parsley, basil, garlic, and some salt and pepper. To this we add about 4 tablespoons of olive oil and then spoon it over the ratatouille. Cover with foil and then bake at 375 degrees for about 40 minutes. Take the foil off and then bake for 20 to 30 minutes more until you have this gorgeous color on top. And that's it, ratatouille fit for the critic Anton Ego himself. Hey everyone, it's Ariana, and today I'm gonna show you the most amazing recipe for zucchini bread. It's one of my favorite things to make on a day like today, which was super gloomy, and it's so sweet and satisfying and delicious. Don't be fooled by the zucchini in there. It is so addicting. In a mixing bowl, you're gonna wanna whisk together 2 eggs, then add in 1/2 cup of your sweetener of choice. I love using maple syrup, and 1/2 cup of oil. I like using melted coconut oil. After that, add in 1/8 teaspoon of baking powder, 1 teaspoon of cinnamon, 1/2 teaspoon of nutmeg, 1 teaspoon of baking soda, 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract, and 1 teaspoon of salt. Then add in a medium grated zucchini, this is about 1 cup, and 1.5 cups of whole wheat flour. After that, just whisk it up until it turns into this gorgeous batter. Preheat your oven to 350 degrees and then get yourself whatever vessel you like to bake your bread in. I love using this bread loaf pan. I greased it with a little bit of coconut oil and then added in the batter. Bake your bread for about 1 hour until it's super fluffy and golden on top. I love to cut the bread into slices. Look how fluffy and gorgeous it looks on the inside. You've got to try this recipe and follow for more. Hey everyone, it's Ariana, and today I tried making these adorable and squishy little milk truffles. They're literally only made with 4 ingredients, and I saw this recipe by Christina Yin and needed to try it for myself. I kept the base of the recipe pretty similar, but put my own little twist on it, added 1/2 cup of milk, 2 tablespoons of honey, 4 tablespoons of cornstarch, and 1/2 teaspoon of vanilla. And then whisk it up until there are no more clumps. Next, you're gonna wanna take this mixture and put it on the stove on medium heat for about 5 minutes. You'll notice it'll get super thick and sticky and turn into this really interesting dough. After that, take the mixture and transfer it to a bowl and knead it for about 1 minute. I tried doing this with my hands, but it was so sticky, so I stuck to a spatula. Sprinkle your hands with cornstarch and then break off a piece to roll into a truffle, and it should look something like this. And then just repeat with the rest of the mixture. Top them off with cocoa powder or sprinkles or whatever you like, and you're done. I've gotta admit, these tasted a little bit strange, but they were so fun to make, so I'd recommend you give it a try. And that's it, follow for more recipes. Hey everyone, it's Ariana, and today I'm gonna show you how to make some of the best pancakes I've ever had. They're so fluffy and delicious. I'm calling these cloud pancakes because the secret is to fold in beaten egg whites, which gives them this incredible airy texture. In a bowl, you're gonna wanna combine 1.5 cups of flour, 3 tablespoons of powdered sugar, 2 teaspoons of baking powder, and 1 pinch of salt, and whisk it all up. Set your dry ingredients aside, and then in a separate bowl, add 1 egg yolk, 4 tablespoons of melted butter, 1 1/4 cups of milk, and 1 teaspoon of vanilla. And whisk this all together as well. Then you're gonna wanna beat 3 eggs in an electric mixer until you have stiff peak. Whisk your dry ingredients into your wet ingredients, and then you're gonna wanna take those egg whites and super gently fold them into the mixture. This is the key right here to making the perfect fluffy pancakes. look at this gorgeous fluffy batter. I know it's a little bit of work, but it is so worth it. Get yourself a nice hot pan, add some oil, and then cook the pancakes on both sides till they're nice and crispy. I top them off with some fresh berries and a drizzle of honey. If you're a pancake lover like me, you have to try this recipe and follow for more. Hey everyone, it's Ariana, and today I'm going to show you how to make the fluffiest homemade naan bread. It's seriously the best thing ever, and it is so much fun to make. First, we're going to add in a cup of hot water to our mixing bowl, and then add in a tablespoon of sugar and a fourth of an ounce of yeast. Whisk this up, and then set it aside to bloom for 10 minutes. Afterwards, it should be super bubbly, and then we can add in 2 1/4 cups of flour, a tablespoon of oil, half a cup of Greek yogurt, and a teaspoon of salt. Then, all you have to do is mix it up until a shaggy dough forms, turn it over onto the counter, make sure you flour it because it might stick, oh hey little buddy, and then knead for about 10 minutes. Until you have a super smooth and elastic dough. Set your dough back into the bowl, cover it with plastic wrap, and put it into a warm, dry place to rise for about an hour. After an hour, your dough should have doubled in size. You want to punch it down and then turn it over onto your countertop. I like to cut it into 8 even pieces and then roll it out. Cook your naan breads in a super hot pan until they're nice and golden brown. I love to use cast iron, and then if you like, brush with melted butter and top with fresh herbs. This is literally the most foolproof bread recipe. It is so amazing, and you have to try it. Follow for more. Good morning, it's Ariana, and today I'm gonna show you how to make a toad in a hole sweet potato. It's one of my go-to breakfasts, and it's so satisfying and delicious and easy to make and keeps me full during online school. First, you're gonna wanna take a sweet potato and stab it all over with a fork and put it in the microwave for 6 minutes. When you take it out, it's gonna be all pillowy and soft on the inside. You're gonna wanna take that part and scoop it out into a bowl. Make sure to save the skins for later, and then we're gonna season the inside with some salt, pepper, and olive oil. You can add whatever seasonings you like, but I like to keep it simple in the morning. And then mash it all up with a fork. From here, all you need to do is take that inside part and scoop it back into the sweet potato skins and make a little well to crack your eggs. I love to crack an egg right into that inside part and then season it up with some salt, pepper, and some red pepper flakes. Then just throw it into the oven at 400 degrees for 5 to 10 minutes until the egg is cooked the way you like it. If you love sweet potatoes, you have to try this out and follow for more recipes. Hey everyone, it's Ariana, and Travis Scott recently released his burger order. Say what you will about this man, he has good taste, so we're gonna be recreating it at home. I started off with 4 quarter-pound patties that I seasoned up with some salt and pepper on both sides and then took it to the grill. You can also do this inside on a pan and sear it for a couple minutes on each side. Then, starting out in a cold pan, I added in 3 strips of applewood smoked bacon and cooked them on the stove on medium heat until they were crispy. Oh, just listen to that sizzle. To assemble, we start out with 2 toasted sesame buns, cheese, the burger, another piece of cheese, the bacon, some beautiful shredded lettuce, dill pickles, and then we send in the condiments. The burger was getting too tall for the frame, so I had to squish it down a little bit before adorning it with some sliced onions. And look at that. Oh, Cactus Jack definitely knows what's up. Hey everyone, it's Ariana, and today I'm gonna show you how to make the easiest 3-ingredient homemade ice cream. I'm not even kidding when I tell you this is one of the best ice creams I've ever had, and it's so much fun and so simple to make. First, you're gonna wanna add a pint of whipping cream into an electric mixer and whip it until stiff peaks form, and then whip in a can of sweetened condensed milk. This part is so satisfying, plus a teaspoon of vanilla. This ice cream base only has 3 ingredients, but you can add whatever mix-ins you like and then pour it into a container and smooth it out. I love to use a bread loaf pan because it reminds me of one of those ice cream containers that you buy at the store. Freeze for 5 hours or overnight, and then look at that. You have the most beautiful homemade ice cream. It's so creamy and delicious. I cannot get enough. If you love ice cream, you have to make this recipe and follow for more. Hey everyone, it's Ariana, and I'm gonna show you how to make my go-to healthy brownie bites. They're so chocolatey and delicious. Go in the kitchen and make these, you will not regret the trip. In a large bowl, you're gonna wanna add 3/4 cup of Greek yogurt, and then you're gonna wanna crack in 1 egg. To this, mix in 1/2 cup of whole wheat flour, 1/4 cup of your favorite sweetener, I used coconut sugar, 1/2 cup of cocoa powder, 1/4 cup of your favorite milk, 1 teaspoon of baking powder, a little pinch of salt, and 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract. Whisk this all up until you have a thick batter, and then transfer it over to a muffin pan. I use this cute little mini muffin pan greased with some coconut oil. And then you're gonna wanna bake them at 400 degrees for about 10 minutes. These brownies are chewy and a little bit fudgy on the inside. They're so good, you have to give them a try. I'm gonna go treat myself to some more, follow for more recipes. Hey everyone, it's Ariana, and I've seen so many videos of people showing what they eat in a day, but since I'm completely obsessed with cooking, I thought I'd do my own little spin on this trend and show you everything I cooked in a day. For breakfast, I made toast with an avocado rose. I recently learned how to do this trick, and it is so much fun. I seasoned it up with some salt, pepper, and chili flakes. Then for snack, I made these crunchy spiced roasted chickpeas. And then for lunch, I made a teriyaki tofu. It was so easy and so good. And then the last thing I tried was for a snack, cutting a golden kiwi into this cute flower shape. And I recorded tutorials on TikTok for all these foods, so check them out if you like. Hey everyone, it's Ariana, and if you haven't had dessert hummus, today is your lucky day. I cannot get enough of this brownie batter hummus. Let's get it. First, you're gonna wanna add a can of drain and rinse chickpeas, and then your sweetener of choice. I used 4 dates, a little sprinkle of salt, and about a teaspoon of vanilla, plus 4 tablespoons of cocoa powder, and a little bit of your favorite milk. I used chocolate oat milk. Then you're gonna wanna blend it in the food processor until it's smooth. Just a forewarning, some dates have seeds, and I found that out the hard way. I love to top it off with a little drizzle of honey and a sprinkle of cinnamon, and I'm telling you guys, it's so good. And that's it, follow for more recipes. Hey TikTok, it's Ariana, and I love to cook. So this summer, I set a goal to cook as many dishes as I can from different parts of the world. Today's recipe is coming from Eswatini in Africa. I decided to make a braai, which translates to barbecue and is typically made on special occasions. Since I didn't have a mortar and pestle to grind up the spices, I tried to use a rolling pin, which actually worked better than I thought. And then I sprinkled the special spice mix all over the steak and took it to the grill. I'm not gonna lie, this is probably one of the best steaks I've ever grilled. It was so flavorful and delicious. Hit that plus button for more global recipes. Hey everyone, it's Ariana, and a little while ago I saw this recipe by Justine Snacks for these amazing fluffy apple pancakes. I love making them for breakfast, and I'm gonna show you how to do it. First, I get an apple and then chop it up, put it into a bowl, and stick it into the microwave for about 3 minutes until it's nice and soft. Then in a blender or food processor, I add in 1/3 cup of oats, and then I add in an egg and an egg white to make sure it's nice and fluffy, along with 1/4 teaspoon of baking powder, cinnamon, and salt. Then I add the apples in there with a little dash of vanilla. Then I take that aside, blend it up, and then I add coconut oil to a nice hot pan and let that melt. And then I add the batter in a little scoop at a time. I like to make these pancakes nice and mini. Then finish cooking them on both sides. Look at that flip. Oh, they look so pretty. Just repeat with the rest of the batter, and then I like to stack them up. Look how gorgeous and fluffy that looks. I cannot get enough of this recipe. It's so delicious and so fluffy and such a filling breakfast. I can't get enough. Hey everyone, it's Ariana, and what if I told you you could make these beautiful, fluffy, and easy soft pretzels with only 5 ingredients? Whew, let's get it. First, you're gonna wanna add 1¾ cups of whole wheat flour, along with 2½ teaspoons of baking powder, a pinch of salt, and 1 cup of Greek yogurt. And that's it, just mix it all up until a dough is formed. The Greek yogurt helps give the dough a super awesome chewy texture, just like the ones you find at the mall. Now I just use my hands to knead the dough together until it's sort of smooth and form it into a ball, cutting it into 8 equal pieces. Then I roll it into a sort of snake, and then get a baking tray, and it's sort of a learning curve, but formed it into my best pretzel I could. And then I brush them with a beaten egg, which helps them get super golden in the oven. Finally, I top them off with some coarse sea salt. You could also do cinnamon sugar or honey, and then put them in the oven at 400 degrees for 20 minutes. Oh, and this step is optional, but so good. I love to brush them with a little bit of melted butter. And we're done. Follow for more recipes. Hey everyone, it's Ariana, and today I'm gonna show you how to make these puffy and delicious oven-baked churros. Churros are one of my favorite desserts of all time, and what I love about this recipe is you can literally eat a whole plate of them and not feel an ounce of regret. In a saucepan, you're gonna wanna combine 1/3 cup of coconut oil or butter, 2 tablespoons of brown sugar, 1 pinch of salt, and 1 cup of water. Bring this to a simmer and then add in 1 cup of flour. I used whole wheat flour and mix it in using a wooden spoon until you have a dough. I like to stir it for a little while to help it cool down so that the eggs don't cook when we add them in. And then after about 45 seconds, I add in 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract and then add in 1 egg at a time. I added 2 eggs in total and then stir until the dough is smooth and sticky. From here, I like to transfer it to a piping bag with a jagged tip. You can also use a Ziploc bag, that works just fine, and then pipe it onto a nonstick baking sheet. You can pipe the churros into whatever shape you like. I threw in a little heart. Bake at 350 for about 10 minutes, and then for the last couple minutes, put it under the broiler so that they get nice and crispy. I love to top them off with some cinnamon and coconut sugar. This recipe is so good. Give it a try and follow for more recipes.